Hello and welcome to another installation of my botanical medicine and magic art. And so today I'm going to be watercoloring cannabis. And while I'm watercoloring cannabis, I just wanted to share some things about cannabis and my love for this magical medicinal plant. So before we get deep into it and I pull up medical studies and things of that nature, because I know some of y'all need the science, I got you, I understand. I just wanted to talk about my own personal exploration and journey with the medicinal goddess that is cannabis. And just a quick disclaimer, whenever you're looking up information or gathering information, please do your own research. I'm not saying that what I'm about to share is not accurate or true, but that you should always take responsibility and find the facts yourself, gather the information yourself. Not only is this super empowering, but it shows that what you're discovering is even more truth. You just make sure that what it is truth. Always look for the truth and nothing but truth. Anyways, I will move on now and talk about my own personal experience with the lovely botanical cannabis. So, I discovered cannabis probably after high school. Not that I didn't know about it, but that I was always like, it was always drilled into my mind that cannabis was this evil thing and all these crazy nonsensical things. And little me was pretty susceptible to that and believed everything the adults told me, even though I was a rebel. Very confusing. Anyway, I digress. And when I finally decided to just give her medicine a try and see what I would experience, it was probably one of the most fun things ever. And that was because younger me was using this primarily for recreational purposes, where there are a variety of ways you can use it. Like, sure, it can be used recreationally, not that that's a problem, but I also found myself using it for various medicinal reasons, using it for stress relief and calming down anxiety, just grounding myself and centering my mind. Since, at least for me personally, I am the kind of person whose head is always in the sky. I mean, I'm an air sign, air sun, and a water moon, Pisces. So, I'm out of here. I'm astral projecting, y'all. But anyways, I just found that it was super grounding, and it just helped me be here now, and be okay with being here now. And what's the coolest thing about this is that, to me, in those moments, that was like a ritual for me. It was a ritual to just be grounded, be here and now, and honor my presence, honor giving my attention to my presence. And to find out later through one of my beautiful sisters, her name is Maria, and I will link her Instagram in the description, because she just has so many amazing things to say about this plant, and she's worked with cannabis for a very long time and will be holding like rituals with cannabis. I'm gonna give her that shout out there, and I'm looking really forward to that. But there are plenty of ancient cultures and traditions that use cannabis in ritual, in sacred ceremony. It doesn't blow my mind, but it blows my mind, and it makes me really happy that this information is out there so that people who are more spiritually inclined even and do engage in cannabis recreationally, you know, maybe here and there you can hold a little ritual for yourself, make it sacred, really ground into the energy that you want to manifest and attract into your life, you know. I'm just putting that out there. I definitely give so much gratitude to this plant medicine. I'm pretty sure, actually, one of the first plant medicines that I, on my very own, decided to discover and trek. I don't even think my parents really used the Civil War or anything like that. At least not from what I remember. But thank you, Cannabis. You've helped me with so much. And I'll continue to honor you and share everything I know about her. And something I just really want to really ground in people's minds is that things aren't inherently good or bad, right? It's about doing things in balance. It's about doing things in moderation. I mean, too much of anything is not good for you. You're unbalanced now, and things are excessive and others are deficient. But when you can really work with this plant medicine or anything in life, from having friendships to sex life, doing things in a healthy, balanced way, in moderation, making sure that you have no excess energy in one opposition and deficient energy in the other opposition, things just can unfold in the beautiful, spiritually light-hearted nature that life is really meant to be. So yeah, that's my little personal take on the beautiful medicine of cannabis. And so now I will get a little more into the nitty-gritty factual things that so many people like to hear as well. And it is really nice to hear, because it's good to know what these things help you with and that it was proven to like actually help. So I got some information from the Harvard Medical School on medical marijuana, just so we can go over that. And any links to all of the studies or medical journals that I'm talking about, I will also have in the description for you to go ahead check out yourself. So let's get into it. If we're going to talk about cannabis, let's talk about it at least from the least controversial aspect of it, which would be the extract from the hemp plant known as CBD. When people think of cannabis or marijuana, they think of THC, which is the part that gives you the fun high. But when we're talking about CBD dominant strains, most of them, if not all, have little to no THC. And patients who use CBD medical marijuana report that they have very little to no alterations in consciousness. Now, what patients do report on the benefits of CBD are from relieving insomnia to anxiety to spasticity and pain, or just treating potentially life-threatening conditions such as epilepsy. And actually, there's a particular form of childhood epilepsy called Dravet syndrome that is pretty much impossible to control. But there have been responses dramatically to a CBD dominant strain called Charlotte's Web that are helping these children deal with the pain of epilepsy. Most commonly, medical cannabis and marijuana, at least in the United States, is for inflammation and pain control. People who just have severe pain and need something to alleviate that. When, especially for those who cannot have Advil or Aleve because they have problems with their kidneys or ulcers, they have medical cannabis as a means to support them now. Not only that, one of the most interesting parts of it is that it's impossible to overdose on, and it's far less addictive than opioids that people would probably most likely give you in hospitals for extreme pain. Like, why is it normalized to use something like morphine that's super strong and harsh on the body when someone can literally just ingest CBD? Like, get it prescribed to them and everything for their specific body and needs and all of those things. It's just insane. Medical cannabis is also used as a muscle relaxant, since, I mean, if you see the trend of helping with anxiety and stress and things like that, it calms the nerves, quite literally. And it has the ability, or at least people swear by it, to lessen the tremors of Parkinson's disease. Medical cannabis has also been used to manage with nausea, weight loss, treat people with glaucoma. It's really promising in the area of research that people are doing right now with PTSD and veterans, and people who are returning from combat zones with all this trauma. And a lot of therapists and veterans have reported drastic improvement. And honestly, I can even vouch for it helping dramatically with menstrual cramps and PMS. Just really calming the nerves of your freaking uterus punching itself. To just be able to go through that process like the beautiful release that it's meant to be for all of us women. And honestly, the reason that it hurts so much, I can really go into that forever, but I'm gonna leave that for another video. All I'm gonna say is, ladies, stop using chemical-rich pads. Please just use organic cotton pads at the very least, or cloth pads. Do yourself the favor. Love you, girls. But I mean, it's been shown to help. From things to fibromyalgia, to endometriosis, to Crohn's disease and irritable bowel syndrome. Like, the possibilities with medicinal cannabis are endless. One of my favorite websites to go to find really informative studies and medical journals would be ncbi.gov, which is the National Center of Biotechnology Information. And they have studies upon studies of various medicinal plants. So what this study here is informing is that endocannabinoids and their receptors are found throughout the human body, in our nervous systems, in the internal organs, in the connective tissues, the glands, and the immune cells. The endocannabinoid system is a system that's responsible for regulating and balancing of the immune response, communication between cells, appetite and metabolism, memory, and so much more. So when CBD acts upon the receptors in the endocannabinoid system, it promotes homeostasis in the body, as well as decreased inflammation. Additionally, deficiencies in ECB signaling could be involved in the development of depression. And like I said earlier, anything used in excess is going to be harmful. The study also lists some adverse effects of using cannabis recreationally. Just, you know, always gotta see both sides to the story. Always gotta make sure that we got all the facts checked out, you know? Because I'm not trying to feed you falsified information. Like I said, I'm all about sharing the truth and knowing the truth of the situation. So definitely please give that a read so that you can also know what happens during long-term usage, especially long-term usage for those who start in adolescence. Though if we are talking about using it recreationally, pretty sure we're talking about THC in this case. There's no specification whether it's THC or CBD, but as I said in the previous note, CBD does not have any kind of psychoactive properties. If there's any information you're down to share, I'm always down to read and learn more about it. There's so much good information and studies out there. Share your studies, research sites. I'm all ears. In the conclusion, the study does touch base on the lingering controversy of using botanical cannabis for medical purposes, but they do still urge, in the end, to explore the likelihood of giving patients access to this kind of a treatment. It's time we bring back plant medicine and reconnect to our ancestors' ways of handling things gently and more in tune with the body and nature. And for all my witchy friends out there, some magical properties to cannabis include healing, love, visions, and meditation. It's even being used in divination, making the buds, tops, and seeds into incense for scrying. Thank you so much for watching, and if you want to learn more about plant medicine, check me out on Instagram @PriestessOfMoonlight. Blessed be.